Hey everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the latissimus dorsi muscle.
Here we can see a posterior view of the skeleton and we can see the latissimus dorsi in isolation. Let's take a look at its origins. Highlighted here in red are the origins of the latissimus dorsi. That's on the inferior angle of the scapula. The spinous processes are the vertebrae T7 to T12, the inferior third or fourth rib, and then also on the hip here, specifically on the iliac crest. So you might have noticed before that I didn't have any of the lumbar vertebrae highlighted in red, and that's because this thoracolumbar fascia here is what connects onto those lumbar vertebrae. So the thoracolumbar fascia is this lighter area right here. And we have the fibres of the latissimus dorsi coming down here and connecting into the thoracolumbar fascia. So the thoracolumbar fascia is an origin point of the latissimus dorsi, but the thoracolumbar fascia is what connects to those lumbar vertebrae. So now we can see an anterior view of the scapula and the humerus here. And you can see highlighted here in blue the insertion of the latissimus dorsi muscle, and that's going to be on the intertubular groove of the humerus. Now the intertubular groove is also known as the bicipital groove, and that's because the long head of the biceps brachii tendon passes down this area here and it sits inside that recess of the bicipital groove.
So let's go over the actions next. So the latissimus dorsi is originating on the posterior of the body here, coming around and connecting onto the anterior portion of the humerus on that bicipital groove. So as a contraction happens from this abducted position, it's going to pull the humerus back towards the midline of the body. So that's going to result in adduction, which is going to be our first action. Next, if we got the humerus up here, so the shoulder's in a flex position, and that contraction happens, it's going to pull the humerus backwards, so we'd have extension as our next action. So both those movements are probably ones you're familiar with, as the latissimus dorsi is well known for pulling movements, such as pull-downs, pull-ups or vertical rowing. But in addition to that, there's also stabilization aspects of it. It's involved in the start of the deadlift to stop the bar drifting away from your body. So that extension of the humerus is what's going to keep that bar pulled close to your body in a deadlift, for example. Now, this next action is one you're probably not so familiar with. So we've got the latissimus dorsi coming around here, connecting onto that anterior portion of the humerus. So as it contracts now, it's going to twist the humerus around to the anterior of the body. So that'd be medial rotation of the humerus. So the latissimus dorsi can also medially rotate as well. So thanks for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. Press these buttons down there because it really helps our channel. As well, I've got a link in the description to the website. And on the website, I've got a more in-depth article on the latissimus dorsi. I go over stuff like the innervation, the blood supply, lots of other stuff. So if you want to learn some more details about the latissimus dorsi, check out that link, take a look. Thanks for watching again, everyone. I'll see you all next time.